So last week, I really thought we were done with certificates, but no. This week, there's another new Azure Cert, but also a ton of updates for Azure Kubernetes Services, or AKS, and a neat update to static functions. I'm Lars Klint, purveyor of fine cloud news and gourmet computing services. This week also marks 36 years since the first Blockbuster store opened in Dallas, Texas, with an inventory of 8,000 VHS and 2,000 beta tapes. I know. As we know, the fate of Blockbuster was the cloud and online streaming services. All right, on with the news. Yes, there is another new Azure exam. This time it falls within the data segment of the Azure spectrum with a certification focus on Cosmos DB. The numbering is DP420, which indicates a new branch of data certification. So far we have seen DP100, 200, 300, and 900 series of certifications, so 400 might be a branch of more specialized exams such as for Cosmos DB. So who is this new exam for then? According to Microsoft, it is for developers that work with designing and implementing data models and data distribution, loading data into a database created with Azure Cosmos DB, and optimizing and maintaining the solution. Very specific to Cosmos DB then. However, its other focus is on how to design, implement, and monitor solutions that consider security, availability, resilience, and performance requirements. Actually, instead of me quoting Microsoft, let's talk to Mark Brown, Principal Project Manager for Cosmos DB, and Gary Hope, Program Manager for Cosmos DB as well, because they probably know a lot more about this than me. Yeah.
We're really excited to have this certification because we know it's going to have a great impact on customers and users as they go and design and build apps. You don't design for Cosmos the same way you would, say, a relational database. There's other things that require some specialized knowledge and different techniques to design for a database like Cosmos. Because to grow for really large workloads with like a relational database, you would just increase the size of the VM it's working on. It's a scale-up database. Cosmos is a scale-out database. So you don't increase the size of the VM or pieces of compute, you just keep adding pieces of compute. So that means we have to partition or shard our data. This is why we have the exam, is to unlock that promise for that kind of infinite scale. You have to understand how to design and model.
This really gives us an opportunity to get into the depth. There's a lot to it. It's got its own query language. It's a dialect of SQL. We have a whole set of SDKs that people need to understand and grasp in order to leverage the capability correctly. So it gives us that ability to get into the detail for that audience much better. Quite a specialized exam focusing just on the one area of technology, which is Cosmos DB. We cover concepts around some of that stuff in the fundamentals exams and learning paths. But this is really focused on that one piece, and it's a specialization exam. So it lives side by side with the other certifications. It's not a replacement or a drop-in for any part of the other certifications. The exam is a piece of the assets that we release. There's also the learning paths, and then the instructor-led content that'll be available to support in-person training as well.
Thanks very much for your time, Mark, Gary. I really appreciate it. The new DP420 exam will be available in a beta edition sometime in November. If you'd like to learn more about Azure and Cosmos DB, check out ACG's free plan. It gives you access to free courses and quizzes, plus learning paths and original series content. And you don't need a credit card to sign up. I'll include a link in the description below. Say after me, containers, containers, containers. Yeah, there were a ton of Azure Kubernetes Service updates this week, so ready? HTTPS proxy configuration support to allow internet connectivity from boot up. AKS support for Kubernetes 1.22 with 53 new enhancements such as pod security admission feature, API server tracing feature, and generic data populators, which are all important, I think. Support for WebAssembly systems interface workloads, which uses crustlets. Crustlets? Yeah, really. To run these WebAssembly modules outside of containers. The controller manager moving out of the core Kubernetes codebase, which means Microsoft is able to update the cloud controller to respond to customer requests that are specific to the Azure integration of Kubernetes. Yeah. AKS support for dual stack IPv6 overlay networking. These features are all out now in public preview. To be completely honest though, I don't understand most of what that means. However, I always watch Kubernetes this month, a monthly show about Kubernetes, obviously. It has Nigel Poulton in it. He's hosting it. Now, it gives you all the most important updates about Kubernetes and is completely free. Check out the link in the description to learn more about that too. There can't be a week without Azure Function news, right? I thought so too. And this week, a new static web apps authentication with a serverless function was released in preview. This is a function that is invoked whenever a user successfully logs into your static web app. And you can use this function to assign custom roles to the user that logged in. This feature provides flexibility in how users are assigned custom roles in your application. And some of the examples that Microsoft gives are: query a database to determine which custom roles a user should be assigned. Call the Microsoft Graph API to determine a user's roles based on their Active Directory group membership. Use claims from the identity provider to determine a user's roles. Now, that is a really cool addition to static web apps, which, by the way, if you haven't tried it, is a fantastic service on Azure. Very easy, very cheap, very fast to set up. Anyway, it'll no doubt allow a lot more flexibility in managing users and roles. Now, before I wrap up, I wanted to mention that the Introduction to Azure Security course is free all this month on the AirCloud Guru platform. And this course is a great way to get the right start to Azure security. To check it out, hit the free plan sign up link below. As we say on the AirCloud Guru team, when one certification rolls into the next and 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 into... Seek and you shall cloud. So see you next week and keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus.